So it's important to remember we started going down the U, and in going down the U, we were actually looking at ourselves from the past. What is our downloading? And then trying to develop some skills in which we can actually also look at the people around us and get to know them a little differently than how we know them in our own little bubble. Right? And that is really looking at people as they are. We're getting to know people, we're getting to know the world, we're getting to know the circumstances as it is in reality today. Right? So if you
Right.
remember, the analogy was we are in this circular room with windows all around, and we can project slides on the windows, and so white windows so we can see the slides, and there's a video camera in a video projector in the middle of the room, and it's projecting stuff onto the screens. And what it is projecting is the past. What it is projecting is our downloading. So we start living in the Google bubble. We're living in the bubble of whatever we agree with, we like, we don't like. It's all our bubble. And that constitutes our reality. So where we started in the U was to kind of draw the curtain a bit and look outside. Instead of looking at all the projections of stuff onto the screen, look outside. See what's there other than the imaginary world we're living in. So this is from our eyes, we're looking outside, right? Then the second step is, these are the levels of listening we're talking about. The second step is the one is you find yourself in the room. Two is you draw the curtains aside and look out. Three is you step out of the room, draw all the curtains so you can look into the room. You step out of the room and step to where your stakeholders are standing, turn around and look inside the room that you just got out of. And what you will see is yourself. You see yourself as other people see you. See yourself interacting with your environment the way other people see you interacting with your environment. So we are interacting with our environment, but we cannot see how we are interacting with our environment because we are looking from inside our eyes. This is like we're stepping out of our body and we are putting ourselves in another body, and we're turning around and seeing something from a different perspective. If you remember from session one, we showed you the video of man going to the moon, turning the camera around so that the people on Earth could see the Earth. Otherwise, they couldn't see it. So these are all aspects of sensing. These are all aspects of getting in touch with reality the way it is right now at different levels. Then we want to create ourselves now in a space, in a mood, to listen for what is the future that wants to happen. Not just what has already happened, not just what has happened in the past and an extension of it coming to the present, but if there was a future that wants to happen in the world around me, I need to be able to listen to it, develop my listening skills to listen for the emerging future, the future that wants to emerge. And that takes us back to what Vivek said. One principle is that the future that wants to emerge around us matches the future that wants to emerge within us, provided we are in the right space, provided we are not being an ego self. If we are being an eco self, if we are in touch with our highest level of self, then we'll see that those two things match. And when we see those two things match, then we can start to be in a space where we can allow something to crystallize, like a future. Right? And then we can go for making that real, which is the part we are going to work on now. But and Vivek mentioned that for this sensing, seeing the world properly, also for creating, presencing, it's better to have a group of people rather than just do it ourselves.